So hello my friends, here am I in Tso Pema in Drikung Kagyu Monastery from Lo Ontor Rinpoche, and I want you to explain a bit about this amazing place, the place I'm staying, the place I'm doing some work, and I would like you to know a bit of the history. Lo Ontor Rinpoche, he was from Kham. He had a monastery in Tibet, he still has his monastery in Tibet. And he has this one that was built in 1973 by him here in Tso Pema, the place where he always stayed and lived after 1973. So this place is a monastery that receives little monks and educates monks. And it's in a very privileged place. You can see Lo Ontor Rinpoche over there in the Gompa, in the upper side of the Gompa. And if I turn around, you come with me and you can see Rewalsar Lake. So this place has a privileged view to Rewalsar Lake, and it's extremely special. And there's something that really touched my heart in this Gompa. It's that they really have so many children, you know, like children that they are orphans. Their parents just abandon them, or, you know, cannot afford to educate them. Then this monastery receives them all the time. And at this moment, they have a lot of children. They really need our help. So that's why I'm introducing you to Drikung Kagyu Monastery here in Tso Pema. Tso Pema, it's really a very special place to me. It's a place to my heart. And I would like to tell you this. And Rinpoche was very, very, very special. And you should see the way his Kandro, Tashidoma, the way she treats these children is like a mother, Amala. The children love her so much, and every time a children arrive, she does everything so these children can feel comfortable. This boy can feel comfortable, cannot feel the missing his mom. She has this role here. It's really amazing. And so please, I will show you a bit of the Gompa inside so you can have an idea of this, how beautiful this monastery is. But yes, it will be wonderful if you know a bit about more of this place, and like what we do in a day here, what is our days in the Gompa, what are the children day, how they spend their day here, having classes, eating, playing, everything. So thank you, and let's go inside the Gompa. So hello my friends, here I'm having a lunch in Drikung Kagyu Gompa, Lo Ontor Rinpoche Monastery in Tso Pema. I had a wonderful lunch with the monks here. You will see, the food is just great. You can look around. she and let's try to go around. Let's try to see. Wonderful rice. So you can see how the boys are treated.
I took full video of it.
Paneer with vegetables. Look at this. So yeah. Hello. How are we eating? This is my sweet. Give me, sweetie. This is my sweet. Dinle Jimpa. Dinle Jimpa. Okay, so now we are going here. They are already finishing. I'll show you them. Say hello, please.
Hello.
Hello. Hello, namaste. Tashi dele. Very good. Did you enjoy your lunch? Okay. See? Tashi dele. Tashi dele. Did you enjoy your lunch? Thank you. Really? You enjoy? Huh? You very enjoy. You? Yeah. You? You? Tashi dele. Tashi dele. Tashi dele. Did you enjoy your lunch?
Yes.
Ah, very good. Also? Very good. See? Beautiful boys. Logan. Nice. So as you see, everybody is very happy here. Especially me. You cannot imagine how happy I am. Especially because I've been having lunch with Gondola. Now we are going to take you to the classroom because boys finished lunch and they had to study. You want to assist to a classroom? Let's go for it. So here I am with Lupin Penzanla. He's the oldest monk here. And as you can see, he's very, very funny, adorable. Thank you. Tuchiche. We go to the classroom. Tashi dele. I didn't hear. Tashi dele. So we are in the first class, correct? We are in the first class. The small monks are here. I will show you so you can understand. And there is the teacher, a senior Lupin. And you will assist a bit of the class of the first year with the small little monks. Let's start. These ones are going to become little monks. They are not yet monks. They are not becoming
Chota la khana le. Chota la. Ah,
So I'm in the second class room. I just arrived and the boys are here. And look at them. Let's see the beautiful young boys and how they behave so nice and how kind is the teacher. So now yes, I arrived to the seventh grade. Let's have a look of the class. The boys are a bit older. Let's enjoy and see the senior teacher, the senior orphan giving the class to the boys. Also, I don't want to interrupt the seventh grade class and distract the boys, and they. So I will be go, but you can now have an idea of their education here in Drikung Kagyu Monastery in Tso Pema. You can have an idea of how the boys are teach, how the Lupins, senior Lupins do a great, great job training these boys and these children with a wonderful level of education. But besides that, they don't only study here in the monastery, they also go out for other classes, which is very important. It's a very wonderful system that this monastery decided to implement, is to teach these classes here, but also children with outside to school to have other classes, which is a wonderful compliment and which really makes his education better and better. So thank you. Now we are going to see them all. We are waiting for the class to finish and we have a surprise for you with them all. Thank you. So, hello my dear sisters and brothers in the Dharma. Here I am in Emao Cafe in Drikung Kagyu Monastery in Tso Pema. And I have here my friend Konchuk, and I'm going to interview him because he is one of the senior lamas in the monastery. And he's going to just give us some thoughts about how he started here like a small monk and how he became now a senior monk. So thank you so much for accepting this interview.
Welcome.
And it was a pleasure, and thank you for helping me upstairs. And I would like to ask you, when did you enter in this monastery?
Firstly, thank you very much for you so came here to help us.
No.
And I came here when I was 9 years old. It is in 1993 or two, something like this.
All right.
Yeah. So I came.
So you came with 9 years old. You were just a little boy.
Yes.
You came from where? Which area?
I came from Himachal Pradesh, which is called Chamba district.
Chamba district.
Very small.
Very small village.
Yeah.
Very good. Then you came here to the monastery and you started a small monk. In that time, you had other senior monks teaching you?
Yes. Now we are the senior.
Yes, yes, exactly. So you are 4 senior monks.
Yeah, now we
are. 4 senior monks.
Four
very
senior
good.
Monks, yes.
So that means that all these boys, it's very important for them to receive a proper education from senior lamas like you and your colleagues. So one day in the future, they can be like you.
Yes.
That you stay here since 9 years old. How old are you now?
I am 38 years old.
38. You are almost, you are here 29 years already.
Yes.
Can you imagine? Means you start when you were a young boy.
Yeah.
And now you are teaching the first class.
Yes.
The young boys like you.
Yes.
And maybe in 29 years we can have all these small children doing like you.
Yes, maybe.
So that's why I wanted to give the example of Lama Khunchul Rösser as a senior Lama. And that's why, because you know, it's very important to sponsor the little monks, those who came from very remote village, a few from Arunachal Pradesh, a few from Nepal, a few from Assam. And I will call Jinpa, come here please. Come here, Jinpa. So we want that this kind of sweeties, little monks, become like these wonderful senior lamas that are so kind and so important to the monastery. And if we give children education, we are raising a better world. And that's very important. That's why I wanted to talk with Lama Rösser. And I'm really very grateful for your kindness. And I would like also to ask you something. Why do you think it's important to be a monk?
Because, you know, outside, you cannot practice yourself. Because it's very difficult to everybody. So that's why if you became a monk and you stay in monastery, then you can practice yourself very well. Because monastery helps you and involvement helps you. So many things, you know, like this.
You don't involve in samsaric activities and distraction.
Don't involve, yeah.
That is very important.
Yes, it's important.
So it's like what is going to happen to these boys in the future.
Yes.
So they don't engage in distraction and samsari activities, and here they have the proper rules and environment to grow with education.
Yes.
And also for benefit mothers and children.
Yes.
That is the main goal. So, Lama Khunchul Rösser, thank you so much for your kindness, for your time, for this small interview. So everybody can understand why it's important to sponsor these little children. I'm very grateful, and again, thank you so much. Tu chi chi. So hello my dear friends, sisters and brothers in the Dharma. Here I am with Kandrola. Kandrola is the wife of Lo Untu Rinpoche that built this monastery, the Drikung Kagyu Monastery. So I want to introduce you Kandrola because she's a very active woman. She does a lot for this monastery, and especially she takes care of these children like their own sons. That is very important because in monastic system, usually the children lack, especially the small ones, lack their moms. And here they have the total love of a mother. So, Kandrola, thank you so much for accepting the talk and this interview. I'm very happy and feel very blessed to be here with you. And I would like to ask you, how is your life here in the monastery with so many children and so many things to take care of?
So, first of all, I really thank Sonia, and Sonia for taking her precious time to take all the photos of the monks, and then she's doing lot of work for the needy people in many places. So here since our late Chabji Rinpoche built this monastery, I think in 1973. Then we tried to work together, bring up the monks and everything. And now still it's going on. So with the help of course, other older monks, teachers, then unfortunately, or what to say, last year, we can say, after the passing of the Rinpoche, Parinibbana of Chabje Untu Rinpoche, then our son, Radhana Rinpoche, he's also a Rinpoche of this Drikung Kagyu Monastery, so he's also helping us, and also others too. So anyhow, to make it short, we are very blessed to have this small monastery in this great, great holy place. And we all will walk together and hope very much that we'll keep up his legacy. Everybody, thank you so much. No. Especially I thank
No, I you. Thank you because you take care of these little children like sons. And it's incredible how they like you, they respect you, they play with you, and how happy they feel here. That is very important. So that's why I would like to see and introduce you to Kandrala. And you already know, if you want to come and visit Tso Pema, Rewalsar, please visit Drikung Kagyu Monastery. And you can also see the little monks and help us in our work and sponsor one of them. They need sponsors because they need to keep studying. They need to keep having a home and having a mom. So that's very important. Please visit Drikung Kagyu Monastery and... Thank you so much, Kandrala, for your time and all your kindness, all your effort in organizing this. It was a bless. So directly from Tso Pema, the sacred place of Guru Padmasambhava and Mandarava, all the best. Namaste. So, hello, my friends. Here we are in Lo Ontu Rinpoche Gompa, the Drikung Kagyu Monastery. So I will take you to have just a small round. Please take a look at this wonderful thing. So as you can see, my friends, this is really an amazing place. Here, the little monks that need some help, they learn everything about practice, rituals, and puja. It's a blissful place, it's a beautiful place, unique. And I could not leave without sharing this with you. Thank you, and may all beings be always well and happy. Stay blessed. Namaste.